Welcome everyone to another episode of the Cruising is Life discussion. This week is a pretty interesting topic. We are going to be talking about the history of the artwork on board the Norwegian Cruise Line ships. As most of you know, there are big giant paintings all over these Norwegian Cruise Line ships, and a lot of them are really, really cool, especially like Norwegian Bliss, Norwegian Joy, and all those cool ones, all those new ones. It actually hasn't always been like that. It used to be that Norwegian didn't even have artwork on their ship, so it was just plain and normal, just like the rest of Carnival Cruise Line and Royal and all those. So their very first ship to ever get this whole artwork, or the artwork on the hull of the ship, was the Norwegian Dawn in 2002. It had, actually I think it was kind of like a New York based ship for a while, so it actually had the Statue of Liberty on it for a little bit. I don't remember if it still does, but at one point there was like a Statue of Liberty on the side of the ship, which is pretty cool. And after that, each Norwegian ship that came out after that would get their own specific artworks. So, like, and it usually had to do something with the name of the ship or where the ship was end up going to be based, things like that. So, like, you had the Norwegian, let's see, the Gem has gems all down the side of it. Makes sense. Yeah, the Norwegian Jewel has jewels, and the Jade has that jade look to the side. Oh, the Star has stars on it. How clever. It's great. So the first one was the Dawn, and then, you know, they started making it, or I guess putting it all on the new ships. The Pride of America actually has the stars and stripes down the side of it. That's pretty cool. So, what about the ships that came out before the Dawn? Well, you have Norwegian Sky, you have Norwegian Sun, where the Sun has a sun. It has a sun on it. Wow. And then, actually on the Norwegian Sky, it used to be the Pride of Aloha, one of their older, or I guess not one of their older, but like when they used to have more than just one of their American ships, it used to be based out of Hawaii as the Pride of Aloha under the American flag and all of that. And so when they pulled that out of their American line, it became the Norwegian Sky, and they just left the artwork how it was. And that's why the Sky actually has like the little lays on it and all that, which is pretty cool. I like it. And then the Spirit has like some sort of spirit like figure, I guess, if you want to call it that, has that on the side of it. And then after, so those older ships got that, and then in 2008 we have the Norwegian Epic. This one actually was designed in-house by Norwegian Cruise Line, by a group of designers, which is pretty cool. This is the only ship in the fleet that has been, that artwork has been designed by Norwegian Cruise Line or in-house. So they actually came up with this by themselves, and it's their only ship to do that. And then 2013 we have the Norwegian Breakaway, which was based out of New York for the first 5 years, up until actually just recently. It just went over to Europe for the summer, and then it's going down to New Orleans, and now it's going all over the place. So for the longest time, it's been, actually its whole life up until recently, it's been based out of New York. So it's had a New York theme to the artwork. It had the skyscrapers, it had the Statue of Liberty, and it had all that. and Peter Max is the one that designed that. And then we have the Norwegian Getaway that was designed by Lebo? L-E-B-O? I don't know how to pronounce that. If one of you want to comment and correct me on how to pronounce that. It has the Getaway was, I guess, themed around Miami, because it was going to Miami for the first few years of its life. And again, we'll be moving around a little bit with the Breakaway. The warm tropical colors that had the mermaid down the side of it and all that, which was Miami. Miami Dolphin cheerleaders are the godmothers of the Getaway. So it actually has a little bit of dolphin colors in it, I think. I mean, it's close. And then we have the Norwegian Escape that was built, or it was designed by Guy Harvey. It was kind of a more sea aquatic kind of feel to it. It has the giant fish on the front. It has the blue as the water and all that tropical watery things. We have the Norwegian Joy, which was designed by Tan Ping, who was a famous Chinese artist. And if you can guess why a Chinese artist made the phoenix for the Norwegian Joy artwork, it's because the Norwegian Joy was based out of China. And then moving on to our last one, we have Norwegian Bliss, which is their most recent and their newest, which actually, at the time this uploads or goes live, I will be on board the Norwegian Bliss for the 15-night Panama Canal cruise. So stay tuned for those videos. Anyways, the Bliss was, built for Alaska. And so it has all the whales and the sea creatures and the turtles and things like that on it. So it either has to do with the name of the ship, or it has to do with where the ship is going to be based out of for most of its life, which is where all of these would get their artworks from. That's kind of cool how they do that. No other cruise line does it, except for, actually, Princess just recently started doing that, but they just put the same one on each of their ships, whereas Norwegian has different ones for each ship and different themes and stuff like that. So I hope you liked this video. I thought it was pretty interesting to share with you guys. And I will see you next video, where we talk about the history of Carnival Cruise Line. So thank you for watching. Click that subscribe button down below, and I will see you soon.